Much more than any other magazine in the world, Playboy magazine has captured the imagination and fantasies of men everywhere. And after spending a wonderful lunch with Candy Loving, I too have my fantasies about her. That she will leave her husband, fall in love with me, and move into my tiny but charming home in Toronto's East End. Your first inclination when you remove that stem is to throw it out. Well, don't. This is very valuable. Put it in your blender, grind it up. You can mix it in with other food, or you can smoke it. It makes a tremendous aphrodisiac. But maybe the union isn't completely to blame, as Stephen Lewis pointed out in his editorial comment last night. The TTC knew the government would intervene at some point, so they didn't do anything. They didn't care much about us, did they? But maybe it's us, all of us, who are to blame for this outrageous traffic. Maybe if we all just filled up the cars. Look over there, look at that guy sitting alone in his car. There's only one guy and three empty seats.
I'm delighted to meet you. You know, my wife watches City TV all the time. Brian Linehan, Mickey Moore, she thinks Gordon Martino is yummy. You know, if I could get your autograph, I got a piece of paper right here. Would you like a piece of candy bar?
Excuse me, I'm a busy man. Do you mind telling me what you're doing here?
I'm Inspector DeLombo. I'm with the Metro Police Department on a special assignment.
You're a policeman? You come into my office, you dress like that, you tell me you're a policeman, you expect me to think you got any kind of credibility dressed like that?
You know, sir, my boss said the same thing to me just the other day.
You know, Mr. DeLombo, anybody comes into my office dressed like that, they don't end up working for me, they don't end up on television.